And ready? Action.
Good morning, Seymour.
Good morning.
How are you feeling this morning?
Great. Great.
I want to talk with you about your diagnosis. Do you know what it's like to have bipolar disorder, Seymour? Do you understand what it means?
You're asking for a definition of bipolar disorder. It's funny because, you know, I walk past your office and on the way out, and it seems like you have a wall full of prestigious degrees, and you think that somewhere along the lines and all the money that you were forking over for that high dollar education that you would have learned what, you know, one of the most widely diagnosed mental illnesses is, definitionally speaking, but maybe not. Education's not what it used to be, right? Sorry.
I know what bipolar disorder is, Seymour. I want to know what it means to you. It's a monster that hits everybody differently. Tell me what it is for you. What is it for you, Seymour? Listen, Seymour, I know it's hard to talk about it, and we could sit here and not talk all day long. We can come back tomorrow and do the same thing. But eventually, you're going to have to talk about it. You're going to have to talk about it, Seymour. Talk to me.
I feel it when it happens. I know it's coming. There's a part of me that somehow viscerally understands what's happening. I'm a logical person.
Mm-hmm.
I've always valued about myself that I could analyze and evaluate and assess situations based on logic and reason. When it happens, it doesn't even matter. There's no amount of logic or reasoning or evaluation or assessment objectively can stop. Me. Or I become it, maybe. And the hardest part about it all, you know, the hardest part about that is that nothing in the world, nothing that anyone can say or do will stop it. It's really scary because when you love someone, you know, you come to know these intimate little details about them, the things that they hate most about themselves. And
sure.
So you learn when you're angry exactly where to plunge the knife. And God, I am astute. I am a studious learner of people, I tell you. I meticulously aggregate this data so that when it comes this time where I'm ready, where I'm angry and I'm hurt, I know exactly where to plunge that goddamn knife. Them hurt. I mean, really, really hurt. And the parts that they hide. And so my question for you, Dan. My question, and maybe you can answer this, is if you know that you're a monster, you know you have the capacity to hurt people that intimately, how do you let them in?
Cool.
How do you feel about that?
Good.
Good.